Now, the code in our previous lesson worked fine if there was just one LED, but we'll run into a problem if we start adding more LEDs. For example, here I have added a second LED connected to pin 4, and say I want to turn this LED on and just leave it on while the other one blinks. Now, you could argue I could do that by just hardwiring it, but say I wanted to add some other functionality in the future, like having this LED controlled by a button or a sensor or something other than this delay command that's telling it to blink once a second. So I still have my DDRD register here. Now I am setting two different pins as outputs, pin 4 and pin 7. And then I have one line of my port D register here telling it to set pin 4 high. I wait a second to make sure I can see that that LED is on, and then I'm going to enter my loop and start blinking the red LED. And when I run this, you can see my problem. That green LED did turn on for a second at the beginning, but then it turned off as the red LED started to blink. And if you look at the code, you can figure out that the problem is that I am overwriting bit 4 in this line of code. So here I've set that bit to a 1, and in this line I set bit 7 to a 1, but I accidentally set bit 4 to a 0, and I didn't want to do that. So ideally, what I want is a scenario where I can change individual bits independently without affecting the other bits. That would allow me to set this bit high at the very beginning and then do whatever I want with the other bits throughout the rest of the program without accidentally changing this back to zero. And we're going to do that using something called masking. So to figure out masking, let's take a look at bitwise operators, which are Boolean operators that operate on a single bit. So first, let's take a look at AND. If I take 1 and AND it with 1, I still get a 1. If I take 0 and AND it with 1, I still get a 0. So in that case, when I have ANDed something with 1, my first bit is unchanged. 1 is still 1, 0 is still 0. Conversely, if I take a bit and it with 0, 1 and 0 becomes 0, 0 and 0 becomes 0. So in this case, the first bit is set to 0. It doesn't matter what the value of the first bit was. I and it with 0, that bit is changed to 0. You can also do this with OR. So I'm going to do the same thing I did on the previous slide, but I'm going to OR everything with 1 or 0. In this case, 1 or 1 gives you 1. 0 or 1 also gives you 1, so that is setting the first bit to 1. It doesn't matter what the first bit was, I have overwritten it and set it to 1. If I OR something with 0, then you can see that the first bit remains unchanged. So 1 or 0 is 1, 0 or 0 is 0. Finally, you can do this with the XOR or exclusive OR operator, where 1 XOR 1 is 0, 0 XOR 1 is 1, so in that case the first bit was toggled or flipped, and if you XOR something with 0, that first bit remains unchanged. So we can combine all three of these into a table, so let's summarize masking with these three operators. If I want to set something to 0, I AND it with 0. If I don't want to change the other bits, then I AND them with 1. If I want to set something to 1, I OR it with 1, I OR with 0 to leave the other bits unchanged, and finally, if I want to toggle or flip a bit, I XOR it with 1, I XOR with 0 to leave the other bits unchanged. So again, that might be a little hard to understand in the overview here. We'll demonstrate it with actual code in Tinkercad. So given what we now know about masking, let's see if we can fix this code so that green LED stays on. I'm going to comment out this line just so we have it there for future reference. And I'm going to write a new line for port D. Now, what I want to do is set this first bit high without changing any of the other bits. And if you remember from the table previously, what we can do is take port D and OR it with a binary number that's either ones or zeros, depending on whether we want to change the bit or leave it unchanged. In this case, if we OR something with 1, that is going to set it to 1. If we OR something with 0, that is going to leave it set to its previous value. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. In this case, that is going to overwrite whatever's in the first bit and change it to a 1. It's going to leave all of these other bits unchanged, which is what we want, because in this case, we specifically don't want to change bit 4. We don't really care about the other bits because we don't have anything connected to them. But now when we run this, You'll see that that green LED does stay on for a little longer when the red LED first turns on, but now we are still overwriting it and setting it to zero with this line, so we need to fix that as well. So I'm going to stop my simulation. In this case, again, I'm going to comment out this line and write a new one. Write port D equals port D. Now we have to decide whether we're going to use OR, AND, or XOR. In this case, I want to set that first bit to zero and leave all of the other bits unchanged. So again, if you go back to the table earlier in the video, that means I want to use AND. I'm going to set that first bit to zero, and then to leave all of the other bits unchanged, I'm going to AND them with one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There we go. So this line is going to AND the seventh bit with zero. That is going to set the seventh bit to zero, but it's going to leave all of these other bits unchanged. So now when I run my code, you'll see the green LED will stay on and the red one will blink, but I am not accidentally overwriting this bit with a zero and turning this LED off. So now that you know how to use masking to control LEDs independently, your assignment for this lesson is to write a program with four LEDs, all connected to port D. One that is always on, one that is always off, one that blinks at a frequency of 0.5 Hertz, or on for a second, then off for a second, which is what we have here, and one that blinks at a frequency of 1 Hertz. Again, you should do this using masking such that when you set any individual LED high or low, you're not accidentally changing the state of any of the other LEDs.